Mary from Sesame Street, and I'm looking for the word on the street. What's the word on the street?
Journal.
What's a journal?
A journal is a book that you maybe write your thoughts in.
Well, I wrote a journal about birds. There's a goose, and this is a gray egret. Place where people write their feelings and sometimes what happened to them in their life.
These journals I like to keep when I go on vacation.
Wow.
So when we travel around, I like to keep postcards and draw pictures.
Keep listening for the word journal today on Sesame Street.
Journal.
That's the word on the street.
Students are great scientists.
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
Do you mean to tell me that kids can be scientists?
Of course. Anybody can be a scientist.
Even Elmo can be a scientist?
Absolutely. Oh. You just need to be able to ask questions.
Yeah.
And investigate.
Investigate?
Yeah, well, that means that you do things that will help you find the answers to your questions.
Wow. Well, Elmo likes asking questions. Oh, and Elmo loves to investigate, too.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
Me three.
Well, that means you can all be scientists.
Then let's do it.
See, let's be scientists.
Yeah.
We're happy to explore.
We'll observe that and this.
Investigate new things. We're happy scientists. We'll ask some happy questions.
Our answers will exist.
Well, just look around and see if there's anything on Sesame Street that you might have questions about.
Okay!
Does anybody have any questions about street signs?
No!
Anyone have any questions about a mailbox?
No! Oh! Oh, look! Look at that! Leela is giving Barkley a bath!
Hey! Maybe we can ask a question about dogs.
Or baths.
Oh, Elmo just thought of a question.
Oh, what is it, Elmo?
Well, the question is, does everyone on Sesame Street take a bath?
Great question.
Thank you.
What should a happy scientist do next, Gordon?
Well, next, you come up with a hypothesis.
Hippopotamus?
No. Hypothesis. It means a guess based on what you already know.
We'll take a happy guess called a hypothesis. That is what you do when you're a happy scientist. We're happy, 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 happy scientists.
Okay, so what does Elmo know? Elmo and all his friends take baths, right?
Right!
And Gordon takes a bath, right?
I do.
So Elmo guesses that everyone on Sesame Street does take a bath.
Okay, then that is your hypothesis, Elmo.
And that is my
hypothesis.
Hypothesis two. Everyone takes a bath.
Okay, now what about you, Telly?
I'm not so sure that everybody takes a bath, so I'll say no. I don't think everyone on Sesame Street takes a bath.
Okay, so now you have to test your hypothesis and find the answer.
But Gordon, how did a happy scientist do that?
You investigate and put everything you find out in a journal.
Like this?
We'll draw some happy pictures, we'll make a happy list. We'll keep a happy journal, we're happy scientists. We're happy, 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 happy scientists.
Come on, happy scientists, let's investigate and find out if everyone on Sesame Street takes a bath.
Investigate!
Well, those are some happy scientists.
Hi, Chris!
What are you guys doing in my bathroom?
We're watching you, Chris.
Watching me?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Well, all in the name of science, Chris. Elmo, Kelly, and Rosita are scientists.
Okay, well, can you scientists hurry this up? I'm kind of in the middle of something.
Hey, look! What? He is in the middle of something! Chris is in the middle of a bathtub!
Yes, yes, and he's got sudsy bubbles all over him!
Scientist Elmo thinks that Chris takes a bath!
Yes!
Yes!
That's right, guys. Yes, I take a bath. Now, can I please get some privacy?
In a second, Chris. In a second. First, we have to draw a picture of you in the tub.
A picture of me?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Like this?
Oh, yes.
See? In the name of science, Chris.
Mm-hmm. Yes, science.
Oh, fine. But hurry it up before all my bubbles pop.
Chris takes a bath. Now he's on our happy list. We investigated it. We're the happy scientists. The happy, 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 happy scientists.
Okay, happy scientists, let's go investigate some more!
Investigate!
Bye, Chris!
I really gotta put a lock on that bathroom door.
What you staring at?
Ooh, don't mind us, kitty! We're scientists.
Well, if you're scientists, I guess it's okay.
You! It's licking its foot.
Huh? Oh, good investigating, Kelly.
Thank you, but why is it licking its foot? That's just gross.
Well, it looks like it's cleaning itself.
No, with its tongue? No way.
Huh? Well, yeah, maybe this is the way that the cat takes a bath.
No, it can't be!
Actually, the cute little red scientist is right. I am, in fact, taking a bath.
With your tongue?
Yep, it's how we cats keep clean. Now, can you stop watching me while I bathe? It's kind of freaking my kibbles out.
Si, señor gato, as soon as we do this, we draw your picture, right, Kelly?
Yep, I got it.
And as soon as we do this, hit it!
Cats take a tongue bath, we're added to our list. We're finding out so many things, we're happy scientists. We're happy, 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 happy scientists.
Now come on, happy scientists. Let's keep investigating!
Investigating!
Now if you'll excuse me, I'm trying to take my bath.
You're sure that's a bath?
Yes, I'm sure.
All right, I'm watching you.
Right.
Look, happy scientists, a sparrow.
Oh, look, the sparrow is flapping around in the dust.
I wonder why he's doing that.
All I know is that a bird who rolls in dust like that couldn't possibly be a bird who takes a bath. So my hypothesis is correct. Not everyone on Sesame Street takes a bath.
Actually, I am taking a bath.
No, you are not. There's no water. How can you be taking a bath without water?
It's called a dust bath.
A dust bath? You can't take a bath in dust.
Well, if you're a sparrow, you can. The dust really helps keep my feathers and skin clean.
Oh, you know what that means? Draw! And sing! Hit it!
Sparrows take dust baths, let's add it to our list. It pays to observe when you're a happy scientist. We're happy, 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 happy scientists.
All right, there's got to be something around here that doesn't take a bath. Aha! Come on over here, guys. I think I see just the thing.
Oh, yes! An owl!
I thought owls only came out at night. What's he doing out in the day?
Whatever it's doing, it's not taking a bath.
Yes, I am.
Oh, you've got to be kidding!
Nope. I'm taking a sun bath.
A sun bath? The sun can't give you a bath.
If you're an owl, it can. The sun helps get rid of some germs that may be stuck in my feathers.
That means draw.
Right. Yeah.
Sing! Hit it!
Owls take sun baths. We're added to our list. We're happy, 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 happy scientists.
given up yet. I just thought of someone who couldn't possibly take a bath. Oscar! Oscar!
Why is Scientist Kelly calling for Oscar?
Because Oscar's a grouch, and he loves everything dirty and dingy and grungy, and there's no way that Oscar takes a bath. Oscar!
Will you keep it quiet? I'm trying to take a bath.
Grouches take baths?
Yes, we take mud baths.
Oh, no!
Oh, yes. So leave me alone so I can wallow in peace.
Grouches take baths!
Oh, let's try and sing. Hit it!
Grouches take a mud bath. We're added to our list.
Stop! Stop! Stop the music! Oh, stop it!
Doesn't Kelly want to sing the Happy Scientist song?
No!
Why not?
Because I'm not happy! I'm not a happy scientist! I'm a mad scientist! Mad, I tell you! I'm a mad, 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 unhappy scientist!
Kelly, what are you so mad about?
I couldn't find anyone on Sesame Street that didn't take a bath. I can't be a scientist, Gordon.
Well, of course you can, Telly.
But my hypothesis was all wrong.
But Telly, it's okay to be wrong in science.
It is?
Yeah, you see, the important thing in science is the process.
Huh?
Yeah, process. It's all the steps that you take to find an answer.
Like asking questions?
And investigating?
And writing down what we find in the journal?
Right. All of those things are part of the scientific process.
Well, we did all that stuff.
Oh, okay. And what did you find out?
Well, here. I wrote it down in my journal. I drew pictures. We found out that Chris takes a bath.
Okay.
And we found out that cats take a tongue bath.
Wow.
And we found out that little sparrows take a dust bath. And owls take sun baths, and we even found out that grouches take mud baths.
Wow, those are some really interesting things you guys learned.
Really?
Absolutely. Through investigating, you guys found out things I didn't even know.
We did?
Yes. And now that you've learned all this great stuff, what do you think the answer to the question is? Does everybody on Sesame Street take a bath?
I think the answer is yes. Everyone on Sesame Street does take a bath, just not all in the same way.
Great job! You guys did it!
We did it! We did it! We did it!
Congratulations, scientists!
But not just any scientist, we're happy scientists!
Yay! Hit it!
I love science.
Hi, I'm Wanda.
Oh, and Elmo's Elmo.
And we're here to tell you about the word journal.
Yeah, journal.
Tell them what a journal is, little E.
Well, Miss Wanda, I'm not sure what a journal is.
Okay, no problem. I'll handle it.
Okay, go ahead.
A journal is a book that you write in every day.
Well, what do you write about in a journal?
Well, there's all kinds of journals.
Like what?
Well, you can keep a science journal where you write or draw pictures of things you observe.
Oh, a science journal.
Or you can keep a news journal and write about things going on in your neighborhood.
Oh, cool. A news journal.
Or if you like me, you can keep a journal about your thoughts and feelings and the things that happen in your life.
Oh, well, Miss Wanda keeps a journal?
Sure.
Wow.
Here it is. My journal.
Cool. Well, what does Miss Wanda write about in her journal?
Well, I can't tell you, Elmo. That's between me and my journal.
Oh, I'll tell you.
Oh, no, you don't, journal.
Oh yeah. Tuesday, August 17th. Dear journal.
Journal?
Today I trimmed my toenails.
All right, that's it. Close yourself up right now. I'll rip that page right out of you, journal.
Sometimes my toenails look like famous people.
Really?
That was between me and you, journal.
Today my big toenail looked like Elvis.
Journal!
Are you ready for some flying fairy fun? Great! Because Abby's Flying Fairy School is coming soon! But first, it's time for the letter F! Come on! Let's play Bring Out Your F!
you know what sound the letter S makes? That's good. Can you do it again? Oh, you got some in my eye. Now, let's go find things that start with F.
Bring out your F! Bring out your F!
Do you have anything on you that begins with the letter F?
Yes, I do. Flashlight.
Flashlight begins with F. Do you have anything on you that begins with the letter F?
Finger.
Finger starts with F. Do you have anything that starts with the letter F? I see something you have that starts with F. It's at the bottom of your leg, and you put a shoe and a sock on it. It's your foot! Whoa! That was fantastic! Now let's check out more about the letter F.
F. Float. This lemon floats. My socks float too. This ball floats. F is for float.
Hey, Jake! What's coming up next?
Abby's Flying Fairy School.
Oh, boy!
Look up high in the sky. It's a school it can fly.
Let's all hurry to the Flying Fairy School. Grab your wand. Bring your wings. We will learn magic things. Let's all hurry to the Flying Fairy School. How to make us grow. And how to make us shrink.
Whoa!
How to solve a problem with a single twinkle wink. This school is really magic, and magic's really cool. Let's go in, let's begin a flying fairy school.
Flying fairy school. I'll be with you in a second. First, I have to find my wand.
Oh, nice crown, Abby.
Thanks. I borrowed it from Prince Charming for show and tell.
Whee-hee-hee!
Whoa! Careful where you're moonwalking, Blog. Huh, I better put it in here for safekeeping.
Wow! Oh, what?
The crown disappeared in my cubby!
Disappeared? Oh, dear. Sounds like we have a cubby creature.
A cubby creature? Ooh, intriguing. What's a cubby creature? Hello.
That is a cubby creature.
Oh, it's got the crown.
And my scarf.
Oh, where'd he go?
I'm not there.
I'm here.
Whoa.
Now I'm here.
Peek-a-boo.
Toodles.
How are we gonna get our stuff back?
To get back what the cubby creature has taken from you, just find the hiding place he's taken it to.
But he moves so fast! How in the name of everything trolly are we gonna find his hiding place?
Maybe you could use some help to spot the solution.
Hey, yeah! Spot!
Spot! Oh, Spot!
Oh, Spot! How do we solve this problem and find the cubby creature's hiding place?
Fetch, Spot, fetch!
Blue, red, green. Let's do it again. Blue, red, green. Hey, that's a pattern. Blue, red, what comes next? Green.
Oh, but what do patterns have to do with the cubby creature's hiding place?
Well, maybe he likes patterns. And if he likes patterns, he'll love these.
What is a pattern, anyway?
A pattern is when things come in a certain order and repeat, like this. Square, circle, square, circle, square, circle.
But all these cubbies are the same shape.
What's different about the cubbies that can form a pattern?
Hey, why don't we do one of those twinkle think thingies?
Oh, yeah.
Twinkle think, twinkle think, twinkle
colors!
Yeah! The cubby creature always pops in and out of the different colored cubbies. Maybe he does it in a pattern.
And if we follow that pattern, at the end, we'll find his hiding place!
Yeah!
But how are we gonna get the cubby creature to show us the pattern?
We need more stuff for him to take.
He already got my borrowed crown.
And my scarf.
Oh, well, looks like there's nothing else for the cubby creature to take. Better luck next time.
Oh, wait a minute. What about your jacket?
Not even a cubby creature would want a jacket like this. Right, Mrs. Sparklenose?
On the contrary, Blog, I think he'd love that jacket.
Oh, all right. But this plan is really cramping my funky style.
Now, let's watch for the pattern.
Time for me to beat it.
Red. Blue. Green. Red. Blue. Green.
Whoa! He went red, blue, green, red, blue, green.
That definitely sounds like a pattern.
Come on! Let's repeat that pattern.
Red.
Give us back the stuff you stole!
Hey, I didn't steal it. I borrowed it to have fun with. I assure you I'm having fun now.
Well, if you just borrowed it, then give it back.
Oh, no. Strict cubby creature rules. I can't give it back unless you call me by my name. Now let's party. Woo-hoo!
Well, what is your name?
Oh, wait a minute. I see what you're trying to do. You want me to say my name so you can call me by my name so you can get your stuff back. Well, no way, sister.
Oh, no. He won't tell us his name. What are we going to do?
Oh, I have an idea. Who wants to play the name game?
Oh, the name game. Yeah, let's play the name game. The name game. What's the name game?
It's a guessing game. You give us hints about your name, and we try to guess what it is.
Okay. Oh, I got one. My first name is something you see a lot of in a museum.
Ooh, what kind of stuff do you see in a museum?
Oh, dinosaur bones!
That's not it.
Vegetables wearing funny hats!
You and I must go to very different types of museums.
Oh, when I went to a museum, I saw lots of paintings and sculptures, and that's art. Hey, is your first name Art?
Ding, 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 ding! You are correct! Boy, this is fun! Woo-hoo! Oh, wait, let me give you another clue. Okay, the next part of my name is something that swims in the sea. What swims in the sea?
Barnacles!
Dolphins!
Oh, fish! Fish swim in the sea!
Yes! You got it! The next part of my name is fish!
Good job, Donnie! How about another clue?
Sure! Okay, what's the opposite of top?
What's the opposite of top?
Bottom!
Yes! Bottom is the last part of my name!
Okay, now let's put the name all together.
The first part was Art.
The next part was Fish.
And the last part was Bottom. Your name is...
Art Fish Bottom!
Art Fish Bottom?
Yes, and Art Fish Bottom is having fun. Oh, hold on a second. Now I have to give you everything back, don't I?
Well, that's what you said.
Wow, nobody's ever guessed my name before. Oh, well, it is the Cubby Creature Code. Here you go.
Oh, my crown! Yay!
Oh, my beautiful scarf! Hooray!
My jacket! Woo-hoo!
This This is the most fun I've ever had! In fact, Art Fishbottom is done taking stuff. From now on, Art Fishbottom is gonna give! Here! Ah.
My wand! Great job, fairies! You solved the problem! And you too! And now, stars for...
Oh, can I give out the stars, please? It'll be fun!
Well, okay.
Stars for everyone!
If what I am is what's in me, then I'll stay strong, that's who I'll be. And I will always be the best me that I can be. There's only one me, I admit. Have a dream, I'll follow it. It's up to me to try. Oh, I'ma keep my head up high. Keep on reaching high. Never gonna quit, I'll keep getting stronger. And nothing's gonna bring me down. Never gonna stop, gotta go. Because I know I'll keep getting stronger. And what I am is
thoughtful.
And what I am is
musical.
And what I am is
smart.
And what I am is
brave.
And what I am is
helpful.
And what I am is
special.
There's nothing I can't achieve because in myself I believe in those. Gonna keep all heads up high. Keep on reaching high. Never gonna quit, just keep getting stronger. And nothing's gonna bring us down. Never giving up, gotta go. Because I know I'll keep getting stronger. What I am is
super.
What I am is
wow.
What I am is
friendly.
What I am is
grouchy.
What you are is
magical.
What you are is
special.
There's nothing I can't achieve because in myself I believe in you. Gonna hold my head up high. Keep on reaching high. I'm never gonna stop. I'll keep getting stronger. Nothing's gonna bring me down. Never give it up, gotta go. Yeah, I'll keep getting stronger.
Are you ready for an adventure? Great! Because Bert and Ernie's great adventures are coming soon. But first, we're gonna check out...
Number 14!
How many is 14?
And now, the two-headed monster will show us 14.
Ah, 14, yeah. Here we go. 14 biggies!
Wait!
What?
That's not 14.
No 14?
No, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 pigs.
Oh, no. No 14!
Whoa. Me 14.
You 14.
Me 14.
We 14.
Yadabo. 14, Chicky.
14!
Hold it!
What?
That's not 14 either.
You want to 14?
No, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7! 7 chickens!
Nana 14!
Oh, no!
Nana! No 14!
Hey! Two head! Don't cry!
No 14!
Just add the animals together!
Add! 7 piggy!
Eat about the 7 chicky!
Equal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9,
10, 11, 12, 13, 14! 14 animals all together!
14!
14! 14! 14! 14! 14!
Hey, you guys! What's up next?
Bert and Ernie's Great Adventures!
Come on!
Every night when I lie in bed,
oh no,
I see pictures dancing in my head.
Picture sleep.
Buddy Bert,
what?
Buckle up and we'll fly away.
Whoa, yeah.
We're adventuring every time the bed starts tapping. Something special's gonna happen.
This is kinda catchy.
My favorite kind of traveling.
Yeah,
we're adventuring. Come along with Bert and Ernie. We're gonna take a little journey. Bert and Ernie's Great Adventures.
We are, ta-da, the Three Ducketeers. Bert, Ernie, and Robert Ducky.
One for all and all for one. Ready to help people in trouble.
And duckies, too.
Oh, yeah.
Marie-Marie, please open the door.
No, Louis-Louis. I am very angry with you.
What am I going to do?
Looks like someone needs our help.
What seems to be the problem, King Louis-Louis?
I ate all of Queen Marie-Marie's birthday cake. It was very small. I went to buy her another, but now she will not let me in. Whoa!
King Louis-Louis, your troubles are over.
The Three Ducketeers will find a way into the castle.
Then we will take Queen Marie-Marie the new birthday cake. Right. And your apologies.
But how will we do that, Ducketeer Ernie?
Great idea, Ducketeer Ducky. Pull, King Louis-Louis.
Oh, your highness! Queen Marie-Marie! I have a special delivery!
Ah! Oh, you see? Marie-Marie is still angry with me.
A ducketeer never gives up. We'll find another way in.
I hope it's a less wet one.
Think, ducketeer Bert. How can we reach that high window? What's that, ducketeer Ducky? Brilliant idea! Easy, Ducketeer Bert. I have a cake up here.
I'm trying my best, Ducketeer Ernie.
Zut alors! It is the Royal Woodpecker. Oh, Marie-Marie will never forgive me for eating all her cake.
Yes, she will. The Ducketeers will find another way to get in. What do you think, Ducketeer Bert?
I think all this water is making my brain mushy.
Interesting idea, Ducketeer Ducky.
Oh, no. I am not getting on that catapult.
Boy, Ducketeer Ducky, this is your best idea yet. You see, Ducketeer Bert here will fly in through Queen Marie-Marie's window, and the minute she sees this cake, she will forgive you for eating her other one.
I hope so. I did not mean to make her angry.
Ready, Ducketeer Bert?
I guess...
Ready, set, fly!
It is hopeless.
Wait, Your Majesty. I think Ducketeer Ducky has another idea. He says that beautiful queens love beautiful songs. So, maybe you should sing her one.
I do not know any songs.
Then we'll write one for you.
We will?
And we'll whisper it into His Majesty's ears so he can sing it to Her Majesty.
Oh, Marie, I am sorry that I ate your birthday cake. But you are my one and only queen, so please forgive my big mistake.
Pomegranate, my favorite.
Do you forgive me now?
Oh, my Marie.
Guess all's well in the castle again. thanks to
the Three Ducketeers.
Birthday cake?
Ooh, yes, please. Nice.
I've had a lot of cake today, but.
Bon appetit. Good night, Bird.
Good night, Ernie. Uh-oh.
I can't wait for Elmo's World. But right now, let me show you backward and forward. Right now, I'm moving backward. Now I'm moving forward. Now backward. Now forward. Which way am I going now?
Backward!
Which way am I going now?
Forward!
Right! Let's keep moving forward! World is on the way.
Once a week, my mommy brings me to yoga class. I love doing yoga. This is my teacher, Maddie. In class, I try to follow and do just like she does. I stretch like a dog. Squat like a frog, stand on one leg like a flamingo. Sometimes I even pretend that I'm rolling down a big hill. At the end of class, I lay down on my mat and take deep breaths, just like Maddie. She puts a little paper boat on my tummy so I could watch it move up and down as I breathe, just like a boat on the ocean. When class is finished, I say goodbye to Maddie and go see my mom. She always has a bottle of water for me. She says it's important to drink water when you exercise. When I grow up, I want to be a yoga teacher, just like Maddie. I can't wait for my next yoga class.
Hey, Rachel, what's next?
Elmo's World!
Oh, boy, this is going to be great!
La 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 la, la 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 la, Elmo's World. La 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 la, la 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 la, Elmo's World. Elmo loves his goldfish, his crayon too.
What do you need to take a bath?
Oh, good question, Dorothy. Let's ask Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle! Mr. Noodle! Elmo has a boo-boo. Okay. Aw, thank you, Mr. Noodle. Elmo's boo-boo feels so much better. Oh, Mr. Noodle, Dorothy has a question. What do you need to take a bath?
What do you need to take a bath?
A bathtub.
Right, Mr. Noodle. You take a bath in the tub.
Ooh, and it's full of water.
Make sure it's not too hot.
Oh, cool. The bathtub is all ready for a bath. So, what do you need to take a bath, Mr. Noodle?
You need to go get a washcloth.
No, those are skis.
Oh, boy, Mr. Noodle.
No, Mr. Noodle, you can't take a bath like that.
Mr. Noodle, stop!
No, they're not gonna fit.
Mr. Noodle!
That's for skiing.
Skis are for the snow.
You don't use them in the bath.
You need skis to ski. What do you need to take a bath, Mr. Noodle?
Try again, Mr. Noodle.
What's that? I think they're for swimming.
Yeah, like in the ocean.
Or a pool.
No, Mr. Noodle!
You don't use them when you take a bath.
You take a bath to get washed and clean.
It's okay, Mr. Noodle.
That's it!
Good job, Mr. Noodle.
You need soap to get nice and clean.
He has a towel.
To dry yourself off? Oh, and what's that, Mr. Noodle? What is that?
It's a bath brush, so he can scrub his back.
That's good.
That's what you need to take a bath. Yay, Mr. Noodle! What are you doing, Mr. Noodle?
Why is he putting on that hat?
So his hair won't get wet.
Mr. Noodle! No! Your clothes, Mr. Noodle!
You need to take your clothes off!
Not with all your clothes on!
He's all wet.
Mr. Noodle, you have all your clothes on still!
You have to take your clothes off to take a bath.
Yeah! Oh, Mr. Noodle!
Silly Noodle. Oh, he's all wet.
Why, Mr. Noodle gave his clothes a bath! What's that, Dorothy? Oh, Dorothy wants to ask someone else. What do you need to take a bath?
Dorothy, this is how I take a bath, with soap, a washcloth, and water.
Dorothy, I like to take a shower to get clean, and to use a nice dry towel to dry myself when I'm finished.
Oh, thanks, everybody! Oh, and thanks, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Oh, hello, baby. Oh, you're all wet. Oh, hi, Mommy.
Hi.
Oh, baby, what do you need to take a bath? Oh, yeah, water. Oh, and soap. And towel. And Mommy. Oh, thank you, baby. Bye-bye. Bye, Mommy.
Bye.
And now, Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you! How many bubbles are in this whale's bath? Let's count them and see.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight,
whoa! Yay! So Monster and Little Mary Sparkles.
Hi, Elmo. Just take a look at Little Mary Sparkles here. It's his bath time, see? He's giving himself a bath. Isn't that something? Look at that. That's the way cats get clean. They lick themselves all over. Oh, look at that. Look at that. He's washing his face now. Gee, Little Mary Sparkles, you must have the cleanest face in the whole world. And the cutest face, too. Hey, wait. What are you doing? I already had my bath today. That's a rough tongue you've got there. Bye, Elmo. That tickles. Stop. You silly kitty.
Thanks, computer. Boy, even kitties take baths. That makes Elmo wonder. What else takes a bath? Let's find out. Oh, Joe. Elmo here splashing. Is somebody taking a bath in Joel? No, Elmo doesn't see anything. Do birds take baths?
Yes, but not in a bathtub, in a bird bath.
Ah. Oh, do doggies take baths?
Yes,
but they need help.
Do cars take baths?
Not in a bathtub.
Yeah, in a car wash.
Do worms take baths?
No.
Unless it's slimy.
He takes mud baths.
Oh, thanks, Troy. Elmo's friend Juliana loves giving her horsey Sarah a bath, and she told Elmo all about it. Oh, you want to watch too, Troy? Okay.
My horse Sarah gets dirty and needs to be washed. So my mom taught me how to give her a bath. First, we rinsed her legs with warm water so she could get used to it. We slowly moved the hose up to her neck and got her whole body wet, but not the face. Then my mom showed me how to wash her with shampoo and a sponge. We washed her neck, her back, underneath her, and we were careful with her legs, and we washed her mane too. It's kind of like washing your hair. Then came the tail. After that, we rinsed her all over with some more warm water. We washed the face last. We have to be very gentle. We used warm water and a special face sponge, but no shampoo. It was time to dry her, so we scraped the water off with a scraper. Then we used a towel to dry her off some more. But she was still a little wet, so we walked her around for a while and let the sun dry her the rest of the way. Sarah was very shiny. I love my horse, but sometimes she rolls in the dirt. Oh no! We'll have to start all over again.
Boy, Juliana's horse, Sarah, must really love taking baths. Ooh, but now, Elmo wants to learn even more about bath time, don't you? How can we find out even more? Oh, yeah! We can watch the bath time channel! Oh, turn yourself on, TV.
Welcome to the bath time channel. All baths all the time. We're all washed up. And now it's time for a bath with the bath lady, Bubbles Martin.
Hi there. Bubbles Martin here. And as you can see, I'm taking a bath. Bath time is my favorite time of day. I love washing. Hey, you want to wash too? You don't have to be taking a bath. You can pretend. It's the next best thing. Okay, everybody wash! Everybody wash your hands! Everybody wash your face! Wash your heels, you know, the back part of your foot. Everybody wash your kneecaps. I know they're here somewhere. Found them. Scrub, scrub, scrub. Everybody wash your thumbs. Both of them. Everybody wash your big toe. That's easy to find.
Next on the Bath Time Channel, Bath Masterson, starring Sophie Sales.
Easy. Elmo wants to learn more about bath time. Oh, boy. How can we find out more? Who could that be?
Want to talk to a bathtub?
Oh, yeah. We can talk to a bathtub.
Yeah.
So, what is it like being a bathtub?
It's kind of draining.
So, how does bathtub work?
Well, you turn on the water with my faucets here, see?
Oh, right here?
Mm-hmm. Oh. And you turn the faucets to make sure nice, warm water comes out of my spout up there. Oh. Make sure it's not too hot, Elmo.
A spout?
Mm-hmm.
Not too hot?
Yeah. Of course, some folks prefer showers, so the water could also flow from my shower head up there.
Oh, up here?
Mm-hmm. No, warm. Nice and warm. But you know, Elmo, you don't need a bathtub to get clean.
You don't?
Mm-mm. No, there are no bathtubs out in nature, but animals can still get clean. Even a little mouse. Yeah.
Oh, look. Dorothy's imagining Elmo as a little mouse in nature. Getting clean. Elmo Mouse is getting squeaky clean. Squeak, squeak, squeak.
Big elephants get clean, too.
Oh, boy! Shower time!
We love to sing.
We love to sing.
Sing in the shower.
Uh-huh.
'Cause we love the way that our singing sounds in here.
Here!
There's nothing like singing to keep the pipes from rusting.
Oh, good! Because Dorothy wants to sing the bath time song.
The bath time song? Oh, that makes me feel all warm and bubbly.
Then sing with Elmo.
Yeah.
Do-do-do-do-do.
Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letter, oh man, I can't remember today's letter. There it is. What letter is that?
F!
Right! F is the letter of the day. But what's today's number? Ooh, there it is. What number is it?
14.
Right! 14 is the number of the day. So Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letter F. By the number 14. This is Murray saying see you next time on